Welcome to Step 3, Understanding Subjects, Resources, and Operations in Kubernetes. And these are critical concepts to wrap your mind around in order to move forward working with RBAC and Kubernetes. And the reason it's important is because we're going to deal with two API resources in order to implement RBAC. One API resource is the role, and the other API resource is the role binding. But before we can do roles and role bindings, we need to understand some basic theory. And the theory is this. Let me expand the screen a little. The way a role operates in and role bindings operate in Kubernetes is we have what are called subjects, resources, and operations. And you can think of a Kubernetes command as a sentence in English. And in English, or really in any language, all languages are pretty made up, all verbal languages are made up in the same way, where you have a noun, a verb, and an object. So in this case, we have a sentence in English saying Bill eats candy, where Bill is the noun, and eats is the verb, and candy is the object. Well, the same thing happens in Kubernetes, where if we go kubectl get pods, there's an implied noun, and that noun is the current user within the context that we're in. And we'll get to that in a minute. But the verb is get, and the object is pods. So let's jump up to this diagram. So when we talk about verbs, the verbs we're talking about are operations. And there are some fundamental operations in Kubernetes. We can list, get, watch, create, delete. There's other things we can do, but these are the basic ones. Then there's also resources. And as you probably know, if you work in Kubernetes for any period of time, there's a lot of API resources, and each of them work differently, and you can do different things with them. But the fact is, we have resources. And in Kubernetes, you've seen some of these a lot. You've seen a pod, you've seen deployments, persistent volume claims, ingresses, services, there's namespaces, there's a lot of resources. And then we have subjects, and a subject can be a user, in this case developer or administrator, or it can be a process or a group. So for example, if we had administrators, these are, could all be subjects. And so what a role is, and this becomes interesting, a role is the association of an operation or operations to a resource or resources. So this goes back to saying that if we look at Bill eats candy, the operation would be eats and the resource would be candy. Or if we go down and look at the kubectl get pods, the operation will be get and the resource would be pods. And there's we're gonna get back to this in a bit, but it'll be interesting to take a look at the reading as we go on.